we equate the Alphorn. It's primarily done with what's called embouchure, or lips. It's all lip. There's nothing, there's no keys, no valves, no nothing. There's two holes, the one at the top and the one at the bottom. It surprisingly survived intact since ancient times. For sure, the Romans discovered it when they crossed the Alps about 2,000 years ago, and it was already in widespread use then. So we know that the Alphorn really is an ancient instrument. Nowadays, the modern use of the Alphorn is, well, a lot in tourism, but they still use it to call their cows home at night and to bring them to the barn to be milked. And a few years ago, I was in Switzerland to study at a Hirschweifer Alphorn Schule, and I was on top of a mountain. My hotel had its own dairy herd, and I kept going ever further and further afield to practice, because people would appear when you play and they'd want to buy you drinks and talk to you and take a picture, and I had practice. So I go out further and further, and my teacher said, Laura, be careful, because you will attract the cows, and then what will you do with them when they come to you? And I said, yeah, that's nice, but whatever. I thought it was a Swiss folk tale. So I get out there, and I'm out there, up high. I position my bell over this chasm, and you can look down and see three villages scattered on this valley about 1,000 feet below, and started to play, oblivious to everything around me. And after a little while, I started to hear that sound of cowbells tinkling behind me. And I look behind me, and there are these cows in this perfect semicircle between me and the edge of the cliff, looking at me expectantly, like, okay, here we are. It is true, the cows still come to the sound of the Alphorn, even today in Switzerland. I would like to play for you a special Alphorn cattle calling song. It is perhaps one of the most famous Alphorn pieces ever played. It's the song of the Freiburger Cowherds. This song is sort of iconic in Switzerland, sort of like their Danny Moy is to us, the Irish or American. And this song was so emotionally affecting of the Swiss that Napoleon, who had hired a lot of Swiss mercenaries to do his fighting for him, outlawed its playing. It would make all his Swiss soldiers desert and return home because they were so homesick. And more than one outlaw, a Swiss, was, as he was being led to the gallows, accused the Alphorn for ending his life. So this is the Song of the Bride with the Cowherds. You will hear the cow call in the middle. You'll hear a beautiful melody. And what you'll hear are these repeated notes. And this is, you'll hear this a lot in Swiss music. This is a cattle call, these repeated notes. Dee-dee-da-da-da-dee-da-da-da. Over and over. They're doing it because farmer would call each cow by its name to this melody. He'd do it over and over again, and each cow would hear its name, and it would come in. So that's what these sections are. When you hear these iconic Swiss pieces, and you hear these notes repeated over and over, these are cattle calls. So this is the Song of the Freiburger Cowherds.